No harm will come to you here, I promise.
I claim sanctuary. I've held the iron hand and I claim sanctuary.
Come out here, let me see your face.
I claim sanctuary, this is my right and protection from Our Lady of the Sea.
And by God's grace, you shall have it. What is your name?
Nicholas Salbrand. What church is this?
St. Mary Quay.
St. Mary Stella Maris?
Some call it that.
So she did leave me here. Sailors talk of mermaids, but I have never seen one or heard their haunting tunes until today.
Are you hungry?
I'm starving.
Well, have a little bread. Not much, but enough. You're not of this parish.
I'm a Yarmouth man. I come from Yarmouth. She let me here. She called me.
Who did?
Stella Maris, the Lady of the Sea.
You're a sailor.
Sir, I have sailed the ships of the King.
To France?
France, Spain, the Lowlands. They hope to get me. And by Our Lady, they'll take my head right off my shoulders if they find me.
What have you done?
They say I killed the man.
And did you?
Does it matter?
Not for sanctuary, but for your soul.
My soul is with the Lady of the Sea. She holds it for me now. Oh, I am thirsty.
Well, I have a little wine. I can pray for you, but I cannot absolve you unless you tell me what you've done.
Is murder not a mortal sin?
All sin is forgivable if the sinner confesses.
There's my wife.
Your wife?
Joan. She come from around here, Ipswich. We try to find her relations, but no good. Sir, I am a rough man. And I have been at sea all my life, but I could not stand any more of that wailing and crying.
Has she been unwell?
We lost a child, a boy. That's the sixth one she's lost in as many years.
The Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away.
Well, so he might. But he don't help the woman anymore, does he, eh? Well, I mean, that was all right for me. After each one, I'd just go on another trip away, but Joan, she has to stay there, thinking on it always. She was a good girl, a hard working right till the end.
Did she not recover from the lying in?
From the lying in, yes, but not the death of the boy. We called him Clement after the patron saint and thought that might protect him. Such a sweet little child, but white, thin looking. Wouldn't eat his food. I thought that was Joan. I don't know what to say.
I can pray for you.
I don't need your prayers. But you see, what happened, I don't really like to talk about it. But I can say this, it will get better. I think later on, when she catches up, it will get better.
So I presume you killed your wife?
Wife? Oh, it was as though she was as good as dead after the third time. She just sit there staring at the wall and staring. Oh, I don't know what to say.
Well, you couldn't go back to sea?
No, I couldn't. I don't know how it's all going to end up though, Father. I really don't.
Did you try and care for your wife?
Yeah, all the time. All the time. But then I would go to this flesh market, and then I seen it laying on the ground, a gold noble. And I think to myself, this is my lucky day. And as I go bang to pick it up, I heard this voice from the back. And he say, that's mine. And he laughs at me as I pick it up, and he kicks dirt in my face. So I say, well, what about a reward then? He says, get away from me, you filthy beggar. And I lost it then, I jumped on him. And we fought like wild savages. And in the frenzy, I push him back and he smashes his head against the wall. There was blood everywhere.
Did you plead your case?
How could I? I mean, I still had the gold noble in my hand. And him a gentleman. I stood no chance.
I can pray for you, but I cannot absolve you.
I don't want your prayers, but what I do need is a boat. I must get on a boat tonight.
If you want a fair trial, you must be here for 40 days.
Fair trial? If I stay here, they'll march me right up to the Cornhill steps and hang me by my neck. But you can give this to my wife, the gold noble.
What would she do with the gold noble?
That is true. But I must get on a boat tonight. Could you change this for me, Father?
Maybe if you put some money into the offertory.
This is all I have.
Give to God and he may spare your mortal life a time longer.
Well, what can you spare?
3 silver groats and a penny.
I'll pay for meals and lodging for 2 or 3 weeks. Yes, I'll take it, sir. Can you see that she gets it?
I will try.
Thank you, Father. And be kind to her. And tell her that I will send word when I am in France. Thank you. I'll see you later.
Go. There's a passage in the altar. It will lead you right down to Bigot's Keep. Go now, my son. I'll try to storm for you. Travel well. May God and Our Lady guide your steps.
Thank you, Father.
I thought you said tomorrow. Room's ready, of course.
No. It was today. Definitely today. I thought I spoke to you on the phone. Was you? Wasn't it Vera Ruddock?
I never forget an appointment. Neighbours can keep the time, they always say, by me. Regular as clockwork, never forget an appointment.
Oh, must have been me then. Probably not clear enough. That's me all over. I'm a bit scatty like that. I have to write everything down now, you know.
Photographic memory. Just have to read something once and it's there. Do the crossword every day. Fight dementia, that's my plan. What'd you say your name was again?
Michelle Piper. This is lovely.
Well, a bit damp, isn't it? Well, let's face it, it's an old building. It's going to be a bit damp. What do you expect?
It doesn't feel damp.
Well, not now, of course. They've done it up. But in the past, no heating. Well, they didn't need it, did they?
Sorry?
The old uns, always wrapped up. And it wasn't meant to be comfortable.
No, I suppose not.
You can't be thinking about your guilt and your repentance if you're too comfortable.
Quite. Lovely now. It's so peaceful, it's a definite sanctuary.
Well, in the past, at least 2 murderers.
Sorry?
This present building dates back to 1443, but there was a church here before that, and at least 2 murderers claimed sanctuary. Well, they could in those days, couldn't they?
Oh, you seem to know a lot about the history of the place.
Well, I'm a volunteer here. I do the tours sometimes. Well, fit in. What did you say you were doing?
Creating art. It is beautiful. Just look at that roof.
Original hammer beam. Can you see the angels?
Beautiful. It's no wonder Mind wanted to use it as a well-being centre. It's just so much
like a sanctuary.
Exactly. How long since the church was used as a place of worship?
Oh, some years now. Second World War bomb put the kibosh on that one as a place of worship.
Well, it's amazing what they've done with the place. Good to see these old buildings being reused. Certainly knew how to build in those days.
Oh, Boys Brigade had it after that. And then CCT.
CCT.
Church's Conservation Trust. They kept it weathertight, opened it for heritage days. That sort of thing. Then there was Keogh's.
Oh, you do know a lot about the history.
That would have been right up your street. Exhibitions, paintings, drama.
And
no eating, of course. Freezing cold.
Now Suffolk Mind.
Did you want to see the manager? She's in her office.
No, don't disturb her unless it's necessary. I just need to set up, really.
They found bones, you know.
Sorry?
Bones! When they were excavating outside. Heaps and heaps of bones. It's probably haunted.
What is?
The building! Probably haunted. You can't go throwing them into a pit. All those spirits, all those unknown bodies wanting their names remembered. You can't just throw them into a pit. It's not right.
Doesn't feel haunted.
It was plague, you know. Plague decimated the villages round here. Worst place was on the docks. They came off the ships, you know.
What did?
Rats! Big, black, ghastly rats!
Oh, can you just show me the room?
Room?
Where I can sit up.
Oh, right. Yes, of course.
This used to be an art centre then.
Funny how things go round, isn't it?
Must have been a bit bleak.
Vibrant, that's what it was. But no eating, of course. Freezing cold. You couldn't hold classes, not like what you're doing.
Well, mine's not really classes.
No?
Well, it's more art to promote well-being.
But you will be teaching them, painting and the like.
Well, yes, if they like, but they can always do their own thing. It's more the getting absorbed, getting involved.
Hmm. Well, it was lovely here. They had little niches and pink walls and sheets. It was really lovely.
Yeah.
Good day to you, Mistress Pounder. Is your husband at home?
Why, if it isn't Henry Tooley, come in, come in. You must excuse us. We had a shipment of flock to the Low Countries, and the muddy yarn and ropes that have returned to us leave us no room for the next shipment.
Oh, you should rent another warehouse. There are two empty on Bigot's Quay, I noticed.
I know. I have said to Thomas, but he will dither so. Oh, if it was up to me. How is your new wife, by the way?
She is well, mistress, by God's grace, and expecting a child by Lady Day.
I wish her well of that. It can be a difficult time.
She seems fit and well, mistress.
And so she might. This is her first, and she is young. But I lost two before Joan was born, and I have lost two daughters since. Still, I shouldn't alarm you. Childbirth is a hazard, come what may. I understand her family are from Newborn.
Yes, of good yeoman stock. And her father had her taught numbers and letters. So I am hopeful once the laying in is completed, she will assist me in the business.
I understand she has a little business herself.
Pulses and preparations for the bowel and the back are her speciality. But she can help with most ailments if you give her the time.
I must see her soon. Poor Thomas. He's had a problem for a little while now. Ah, husband dear. Master Tooley has honoured us with a visit.
We are an honour indeed. Have you been offered refreshment?
Oh, I have been sorting cloth all morning. Ale or wine, Master Tooley?
No, nothing for me, thank you. I don't want to impose on your time any more than is necessary.
Emma, find the maid, if you will. We will have wine, and I will not hear against it. And a little bread and fish, I think.
I want to put you to no trouble.
Hospitality is never trouble. I have seen your wife at St. Mary Quay, have I not, Master Tooley?
Alice is a pious woman.
There is no harm in it. And it is a good church, a worthy church with which to be associated. John Squire is a solid man, if a little schoolmastery. Mm. I intend to have brass there.
Yeah.
Emma thinks it's a little morbid, but between you and me, preparations are already in place.
How's your new house?
Oh, it suits us well. Alice is happy. It has three sleeping chambers and fronts the quay.
Three sleeping chambers. She is clearly hoping for a broom.
Well, the first is already on the way.
And I wish you pleasure of it. Children can be a blessing and a curse, whether they survive or no.
Mm.
But it is the result of life itself, so we must accept our fate. And how's trade?
Woad and wine are flourishing at present, and I do good trade with Bilbao and San Sebastian.
Better than the French port, I won't.
Mm.
They up their taxes every year. The king will soon have to do something about it. You use the Edmund, don't you?
Yeah, I hope one day to have my own ships.
Well, my advice would be branch out to Iceland. Fish is a stinking business, but very profitable.
But is it not hard to get a crew for such an inclement voyage?
Well, not if you pay them in breeches and jackets, half out, half back. That way they won't jump ship when the going gets a little rough. Dunwich men are best. Mark my words, the French will continue to get difficult. They can't be trusted.
Mm.
But Iceland will be rich with fish, and they are content to deal in iron and cloth. Oh, what was it you wanted to see me about?
I wanted to ask your advice about renting properties in the Low Countries, and if you would promote me to the Merchant Adventurers Guild. As you know, they hold the rule there, and it is easier to be in than out.
Well, you're not apprenticed.
No, I didn't serve my full term. I was impatient, and the old man was slow.
And your father?
A fisherman from Corton in Norfolk, but not a trader.
Well, I'll see what I can do. There will be a fee, of course, but nothing too much. A representation from me, especially as Chamberlain, should suffice.
I would be most grateful. It would make all the difference.
Now, I'm afraid I can spare you no more time. I have another sitting before Wolsey this afternoon.
Well, the Cardinal?
Yes, indeed. It's over the William Giles's will. It drags on, sir.
Also a St. Mary's key man, I believe.
Yes, a pious man. He left 2 shillings. For prayers to be said for himself and his family every Sunday. He also left a lot of property which contains sitting tenants who refuse to move out. This will drag on for years, I know it. Never, never agree to be an executor, Master Tyrion, not even for your best friend. I will probably be dead before this matter's finished.
Master Tooley, refreshment is ready.
Oh, thank you, Mistress. Will you join us, Master Pounder?
Go with my wife, please, Tully. I needs must pore over these documents before I leave. And one last piece of advice. Get yourself an agent. No matter how energetic you feel, you cannot be in 5 places at once. Get a good agent, one who can deal with London and the Low Countries, one who speaks Flemish and French, and you won't go far wrong. And look to Iceland, Master Tully. By God's grace, look to Iceland.
Hello? Hello?
Who should I speak from?
I don't think you're allowed to do that in here.
Who are you? Thought Place?
It's not me, it's the law. You know, public buildings, public spaces, all that.
Well, I don't see any notices or signs.
It's there. Sorry.
Oh, crap. Do you know, this country's becoming more like a dictator state every day. Can't do this, can't do that. Can't have a cigarette within 100 miles of some other human being. Can't have a thimble full of wine after every millennium. Bacon will paralyse you. Sausages will kill you. When's it all going to end, eh?
I'm vegan.
Oh, surprise, surprise.
You here for the course?
Intercourse?
Art therapy.
I was hoping that was going to be wine tasting or cannabis growing.
I'm not interested in art.
Do I look interested in art? I'm only here because I have to be, part of my reintroduction into society, apparently.
I don't think we'll be studying the great artists. I think it's more like, you know, self-expression.
Oh, well. If it's live modelling, I might be interested. If some young tart turns up and gets a kit off, I might hang around.
We can hope.
Oh, my luck, I'll probably be some old crone of 90 with warts. Beezer, by the way.
Sorry?
My name's Phil Danny, but they call me Beezer for short.
Why Beezer?
Are you serious?
No.
Dandy, Beezer, comics, Desperate Dan, Cow Pie. Well, sick thoughts, that might not be a very good reference.
I'm not allergic to meat or meat references. It's by choice.
Well, whatever you say, Sunshine.
It's James Cartwright.
Oh, pleased to meet thee, Jim lad.
James.
All right, whatever. So what's your story then, Morning Glory?
I think it's a bit early in the day for life stories, isn't it?
Why? You got a few skeletons in the closet, have you?
Had my ups and downs, same as everyone, I expect.
Yeah. Go on, don't be shy. That's what we're all here for, innit, eh? Tell each other little stories over pots of paint and
cups of coffee. You show me yours and I'll show you mine.
I had a breakdown at uni. Diagnosed with BPD.
What's that to a mere mortal?
Borderline personality disorder.
Oh, so you're a schizo, eh?
I think it's not really acceptable to use words like that these days.
Right, sorry mate, no harm intended. I don't go in for all this PC crap. I mean, why call a spade a cast iron digging implement when you call it a spade to be done with, eh?
This is supposed to be a safe environment.
It's fine, I'll behave. So what's it like being one of these BPDs or whatever?
I'd say it's like the emotional equivalent of being a burns victim. Everything hurts more.
Or probably the opposite. I don't feel anything anymore. Recovering alcoholic, drugs dependency, you name it, I've been hooked on it. Been dried out 5 times. I'm only 23. I've had enough of this. I'm going outside for a fag. You want one?
No, thank you.
Then meet free.
Very funny.
If the gaffer turns up, come and get us, will
you? A mermaid found a swimming bird, hit him for her own, pressed her body to his bone, loved and tumbling down. Forgotten cruel happiness that even lovers drown.
You seem happy today, mistress.
Oh, Audrey, the sun is shining, the birds are singing, the ships are at the quay. I'm pregnant again.
Oh, mistress, I'm so happy for you. But have a care, I beg you. It's been 5 years since the first one. 5 years and 5 little graves.
Oh, but I have a good feeling about this one, Audrey. This will be a boy, my John, and he will be strong. And I'm well, I feel well, better than I felt in a long time.
Have you told the master yet?
I think he has enough to worry about, what with the disputes in France and the wine held up at the port and the builders in.
It's not him has to worry about the builders. It's us has to put up with the mess.
It'll all be worth it in the end.
Messy and dust there, banging and crashing from morning till night, and enough cups of ale as I think it's going to come out of their ears.
Well, they've had a bit of a spark to the house, do they not? And a bit of company.
I know the master's away a lot, but I could think you'd do better company than Harry Mason and Thomas Spragg.
The lady doth protest too much, methinks. I've seen you eyeing Harry Mason, Audrey, and don't you deny it.
Oh, I'm too old for another husband, mistress. I don't think I'd want another one, not after my Ralph.
Oh, Audrey, did you love him so much?
No, mistress, I hated him. He was no good, drunken, no good, downtrodden, and...
Oh, he must have had his good points.
Well, if he did, he never showed them to me.
Oh.
Alice! Alice! Look at this! Look at this!
Oh, Henry, I did not think you to be returned so soon by the lady. I've got nothing in the house. Audrey, to the market and fetch some cheese and some bread.
But did I warn you the Simpsons were coming from London?
Well, yes, you wrote, but you said Thursday.
That is tomorrow.
Oh, by the beard of Jehovah, I have nothing in the house. Audrey, to the market and then get baking. We need rabbit pie, 2 capons, apples...
For goodness sake, woman, just listen to me for a moment, will you? Look at this! Look at this!
An expenses sheet?
Yes, Simon Cooper's expenses sheet. And he charges me £39. £39 for 2 years' work.
Cooper, your agent?
Yes, Cooper, my agent. I paid him £8 a year, and he has the audacity to charge me £39 expenses. Get an agent. That's what Pounder said. I took him in his word. And this? Look at this!
A litigation?
Yes! A litigation from one Thomas Gittins, who accuses me of stealing his wine while he was imprisoned in the French port. This is Cooper again. He's cheated me twice.
Take a breath. You have a seizure.
And this! Look! Look at this!
A bill of sale altered.
Yes, a bill of sale altered. 200 cloths to Spain, including reds, violets, and pony jays, and he records a miserly return of some iron. I've been robbed!
Mr. T, Mr. T,
can explain.
Explain? What is there to explain? You, sir, are a thief. I trusted you as my agent, and you have stolen from me.
No, it's French wars. The ships were held up in port, and the wine confiscated. I had to pay tolls to get them released.
Where's my cloths? Where is my ship?
I bought the Mary Walsingham as directed, sir. She's a lovely vessel. She will do well to Iceland, methinks. And here is the bill. I used the proceeds from the cloth sale to purchase her. And then there was a crew.
Is this your chest?
It contains all my papers.
Where is the key?
Details. I don't have it.
Do you want my man to break open the lock?
No. Wait. You can't go through my papers. It will all prove out, sir.
Your purse. Give me your purse. And your rings.
Sir, well, why? What?
They will stand as surety. What? Now, throw him in jail.
No, you can't do this. I need my papers.
So you can alter them some more?
Sir, I can prepare a proper account.
I will prepare the account. Now take him to the bailiff.
I appeal to Stella Myers. I appeal to my lady.
It will do you no good. I will have Ralph Rathbone draw up the accusation. There will be documentary evidence. I will squeeze you till you're dry. Dry! You hear me?
Hello.
Hi.
What a place. This must go back centuries if walls could talk.
I've just been having a look around. Over there's the famous Pound of Brass. It's fascinating. Thomas, Emma, and their 8 children. She was never buried here, you know. Look at the dates. Thomas died 1525, but there's no date for his wife.
Fascinating.
You here for the art therapy?
Yes. Clive. Clive Dunn. Yes, I know. A little joke on my mother's part, I think.
Sorry?
Dad's army. Corporal Jones. They don't like it, Mr. Manion. They don't like it.
I don't watch much TV, sorry. James, by the way.
Oh, right. Anybody else turned up yet?
Well, there's a guy outside smoking. He said, you must have passed him as you came in, didn't you?
Little bloke. Shifty expression. I thought he looked a bit dodgy, actually. I gave him a wide berth, to be honest.
Oh, the doors were open, so someone else must be here.
Well, I expect somebody will be along in a minute to tell us what's what.
What's your interest?
De-stressing, to be honest. Had a bit of a breakdown at work. Run my own company, you know, pressure of the job and all that.
What sort of company?
Import-export. Loads of travel involved, 25 hours a day. Oh, medication, but the doctor suggested I try this place. You?
Dropped out of uni.
Oh, which one?
Sheffield's architect course.
Sorry to hear that. What are you doing now?
I don't know, really. Not much. I spend a lot of time in my bedroom playing video games, if I'm honest.
Had much help?
I was going to a self-help group, but that was run by a charity and the money dried up. I phoned the Samaritans quite a bit. I think they're getting fed up with my voice by now.
What about a therapist?
They cost money. I haven't got any.
Oh, yes, that's true.
Hi! Are you here for the creative art group?
I am. Yes, Clive Dunn. I know, my mum's little joke.
Sorry?
Your dad's army. Corporal Jones, they don't like it, the fuzzy wuzzies.
We have a strict policy of no racism here. Mr. Dunn, and I would appreciate it if you respected that.
I think it's from a TV show.
And you must be James.
Yeah, there's another guy outside smoking.
Oh, is that Mr. Dandy?
Said his name's Beezer.
Well, I'm Michelle, and I will be your leader in the creative art group. Now, if you'd like to make your way to the mezzanine floor, I'll just pop outside and see if I can find Mr. Dandy.
Should we wait for them?
They're making your way up, she said. Are you for art therapy?
Is this Quay Place?
Yes, it is.
It says on the map, St. Mary Quay Church.
Well, it is. Well, it was. It's been converted. Which I suppose is rather funny, really.
What is?
Well, the church built to convert people, now people have converted it.
Yes, well, if you put it like that.
You're not late, by the way, we were just gathering.
Well, 2 minutes, 20 seconds early, actually.
Right.
I'm here to do some historical research.
Not art therapy?
I was told it could include historical research. Yeah. Michelle's on the floor. She says we need to get upstairs and make ourselves at home. Which of course means different things to different people. I mean, me for instance, I'd start by making a nest out of a load of cardboard boxes and then crack open the old special brew. Joke!
Lisa, this is Clive Dunn.
Oh, I bet you get a lot of stick for that, don't you, eh? They did not like it up, Mr. Mannering.
That's Army.
Yeah, the fuzzy wuzzy, sir. They did not like it up.
Well, be careful, Ramoshelle, if you say that.
Fuzzy wuzzies was a term used during the Boer War to denote the ethnic peoples who were fighting the British.
Right on, brother. Fisa.
Timothy, I'm glad that you didn't do that again.
Right, chill. No arm, men.
3, 4, 5.
Should we go up then?
More safe and more comfortable.
I'm sure, mate. I'm going for another fag.
Oh, after you.
I need to go last.
Why?
I just do. All right.
I smile, although wrinkled blue, lo, the sea is fair, smooth as the flow of a maiden's hair, and the welkin's light shines through into mid-sea caverns of beryl hue, and the little waves love, and the mermaids sing, and the sea is a beautiful, sinuous thing.
Thomas, and the Ram of all places, I'm surprised at you. Have you not wine enough at home?
The Ram is as good a place as any, and I like the company.
Oh, business must be good.
Business is good, but I fear my health isn't.
Come now, Charles, a few aches and pains?
No, it's more than that. But I wanted to wet the head of your new son.
By God's grace, he seems a strong boy.
Alice must be pleased.
Well, she is cautious, but he has a lusty pair of lungs on him and is very ruddy about the face and feeding well.
Man needs a son and heir.
And a woman, a child to harbour their love.
Of course, it is their nature. To John Tooley, may he have a long life granted him and a strong arm.
John Tooley.
Oh, you see that man over there? He is John Barber. Do you know him?
Is his son Thomas not married to your daughter Jo?
Yes, indeed. He is to be my executor. I have drawn up my will, left nothing to chance.
What? It is wise to be prepared.
I had a portent.
What?
The Shrine of Our Lady, that this would be my last year.
But you are being foolish.
Well, my brass is complete. It only needs a date. And I have had a good life, Henry. Been Portman, Chamberlain, and Coroner.
And last year, Mayor.
Yes, sir. I have 2 living sons and a good wife to continue my business interests.
My dear friend, this is foolish talk. You are as fit as I am, if not fitter.
I saw Stella Maris.
Our Lady of the Sea.
In a vision while I was praying, she told me that this would be the year 1525 and to be ready.
Alice says it is all superstition.
Emma says the rosary and tells me the lady does not lie.
Oh, all right. Have it as you may. It is wise to be ahead and make sure you've appointed executors. We all have to die sometimes, I suppose. But I would lay down any coin that you will live for another 10 years at least. Do you wish me to stand as executor?
No,
I have an executor. I wouldn't burden you with that duty. You know I've been executor for William Giles, and you know how long that has been dragging, and well, I will be dead before that is finished. Never, you will never have sitting tenants on your property without proper legal document to have them removed at a moment's notice. No. What I ask of you is a guarantee that you will help Emma continue the business.
Mistress Pounder is a formidable woman. I'm not sure she'll want any help from me.
I know that Alice takes a lot of responsibility in your dealings, but a woman in trade needs a man to smooth things. Someone to deal with the more ignorant tradespeople and agents. Be her surety. This is what I ask.
But surely, your son, Richard...
He is still green and he has my ship. Emma will have her own dealings. Promise me.
Your own drinks in here, you know. There is a cafe.
Sorry, I didn't realise. Biscuits.
We have a cafe that sells a variety of hot drinks.
Yeah, you said. Baskets.
Are you here for art therapy?
I saw the door open. I only came in for some quiet beefcake.
Oh, well, it is that this time in the morning. But wait till mothers and kiddies arrive. Not that I've got anything against them. And the little kiddies have got to get somewhere, and they have got their own toys and space, but my word, you can't keep kiddies quiet. That's what I said to the manager. You can't keep kiddies quiet. It's asking too much.
It's a good job I came now.
Don't get me wrong. We love them, dear little things. Who wouldn't at that age? Dear little faces. Get to five and they can be right little bastards. Oh, excuse my French.
Excuse me, I'm looking for the creative art group.
Well, we're all upstairs. Do you want me to take you?
I don't know. I probably ought to sit down for a minute. You don't mind, do you?
I was hoping for a bit of time on my own, actually. Biscuits!
I just need to count to 10, take some deep breaths, and throw some salt over my shoulder.
Sorry?
Only joking. Counting to 10 should be enough. Is that tea?
Yeah. I brought it in. Apparently, it's verboten. Beefcake! Sorry, biscuits! Bloody hell.
It's alright. It's Tourette's, isn't it?
Only when I get stressed or nervous.
Oh.
I only came in for some quiet bunnies!
Bunnies? How sweet! I thought it was usually a bit cruder than that.
Well, I have alternative words. They all begin with B.
Don't the other ones slip out sometimes?
I try to focus. Brainwaves!
Do you want me to take you up?
It's fine. I'm fine. You just get on with whatever you've got to get on with.
Well, if you don't mind, I have got a few things to do.
It's fine.
I'm a volunteer here at Quay Place. Wellbeing Centre. Come as you are, leave better.
Great.
I've been practising that.
It's lovely. lovely here, isn't it? Amazing what they've done with the place.
You've been here before?
My dad used to help with the voice brigade. It was a bit run down then, but serviceable enough. And then there was Key Arts. I did a bit with them for a while.
You're an artist?
No, not really. More on the drama side. We did masquerade balls, that sort of thing.
Sounds fun.
It was. Great bunch. But that was a long time ago. You move on, don't you?
Well, you didn't keep the drama up?
No, not really. Circumstances, you know, things got in the way.
Aye, aye. Couple of new recruits.
Are you for the art group?
I should be. I've just come down for a crafty fag. Beezer.
Gail, and this is...
Denny.
What one, mate?
Try and give him up.
Yeah, so am I. I'm down to 40 a day at the moment. It's not bad, is it?
Well, it's a hard habit to break.
According to Chicago...
What?
Instead of getting easier, it's the hardest thing to take. I'm addicted to you, babe. You're a hard habit to break.
Bones.
I'll come with you,
Bloomies.
I can do with one now.
Oh, another addict I see.
I can usually resist, but I think just the one.
While the women weep.
Oh, first the fall of Wolsey and now your Henry.
Oh, it was his own fault. You know how stubborn he is.
Why did he just not pay the fine?
It was £40.
I would have lent it.
I know. He says he has been misrepresented.
And now he has been excommunicated.
I know. A year. A year away from the town and the church, a year away from trading in Ipswich and... with life so difficult at the moment.
What will you do?
He says he will try trade wine through Yarmouth.
You'd think being a bailiff and a portman, he would have had more sense.
And just when you think it can get no worse, here comes William Sabine. I don't think I can stand all his strutting and his crowing.
Oh, too late. I fear he's spied us.
Oh dear.
Mistress Tooley, Mistress Pounder, an honour, I'm sure.
Sir.
Mistress Tooley, I was much distressed to hear of your husband's plight. I would have paid the £40 myself if he had need of it. Cash flow can be difficult when trade is tight.
That's very kind of you, sir, but my husband has his pride.
No, pride comes before a fall, methinks. How will you manage?
I have my friends.
But no son to help out in the business.
I am quite capable of continuing trade on my own, sir. Mm. After all, I have kept the ledgers on his behalf for some time now. And made some payments. Entrusted with some litigation as well.
I'm sure you are. Have you heard? I have purchased the house of the Blackfriars.
Good for you.
Yeah, I think our time of being subservient to these priory orders is coming to an end. They are the last. And when with Cromwell having removed Our Lady of Ipswich, there should be a little less superstition amongst our parishioners.
Are you not sad to see her go?
As church warden here, I feel we should move forwards. The king has done well. He has pulled away from Rome, and we must follow suit.
I do not like change, and I am very fond of the cardinal.
No, oh, so was I, so was I. A true son of Ipswich, but he made mistakes.
You were quick to make hay from his demise.
Why not benefit a little from the cardinal's wealth? And it was good cane stone and would otherwise go to waste.
You have plans? I had thought that your fine house, the Stillyard, could be expanded no further without falling into the quay.
No. It's for the church. I do not see why St. Lawrence and St. Clement should have all the money spent, and not our dear St. Mary Quay. And anyway, Dame Gelgit has left money to purchase the fine hammerbeam roof that had been prepared for Wolsey's chapel. So we will have a rebuilding program fit for Our Lady of the Sea.
I am sure your service will do you proud, sir. And your name?
My name is already done proud, as you know. I am a naval commander as well as a trader, and the king has always looked favourably on my service. I remember the banquet at Portsmouth before we took to our ships, with the sound of minstrels ringing in our ears.
If you will excuse me, sir, I have much to attend to.
And again at the feast of the Nativity of Our Lady. Who would have thought after that banquet that Wolsey would come to such a bad end? He seemed to have so many friends.
I will come with you, Mistress Tully, for I needs must discuss the next
Thomas
ship.
Cromwell, absolutely. Roland Lee, Stephen Gardner. But I thought even then that the rain was a portent. So much rain! Still, it's an ill wind that...
As I see it, it's up to you what you do. I'm just a volunteer here. But as I understand it, it doesn't have to be art. You can do poetry or history or woodwork or have a chat or listen to music.
Won't that put the rest off?
On your headphones.
Well, I can do that in the park.
But being with others helps, doesn't it? Company can relieve all sorts of symptoms.
Or create more.
It's all about mindfulness. Creating an environment that's right for you. Have you had a diagnosis?
PTSD. I served in the Falklands.
Oh, really? When was that? 80s?
82.
Right.
You an army man?
Navy. I was there when the Sir Galahad was hit.
Christ, that must have been a thing to get over.
Well, you don't, do you? I mean, I was straight out of training, still wet behind the ears.
You know Simon Weston?
I didn't know him personally.
I saw him on TV quite a lot.
I knew you two, you now. He saved at least 10 guys, but he never really talked about it, but he got some sort of recognition in the end.
So how did you cope?
Not well. Hence I'm here drinking coffee in an old church, well-being centre. Sometimes I wish I'd been badly injured like Weston. You can't see the mental scars. People think you're making it up. But I can't hold down a job. I get anxious, nervous. And of course it brings on the Tourette's. Beaver!
So have you had counselling at all?
All sorts. Keep busy. Treat knowledge your enemy, but as a wound. Well, that's okay, but the others can't see it. It's always there. Forever. It just lurks round corners. Just out of reach. Even now, after all these years, I can't forget biscuits.
Well, the past is best left in the past, if you ask me.
Well, I don't live in the past. The past kicks down my door, rushes in and grabs you by the throat.
Well, when it does,
You want to kick it in the bollocks, that's my advice.
And what would you know about it?
What would I know about it? I was in Northern Ireland, mate, Belfast, 1971. It's nothing you can't tell me about stress. Just following orders, we didn't have a bleeding clue. And nobody wanted us there. Both sides hated us. We've done Shankland Road once. Sent there to break up some gathering. These bastards boxed us in, started throwing stones, bottles at us, then petrol bombs. They killed my best mate. So pointless!
Well, that's the army for you.
What do you think the Navy's any better? Look at the Argies are still after the Falklands.
You want a round, mate? I was just about ready for one.
You want to come back with me?
This building is a sanctuary. Violence and raised voices are not tolerated in this building.
It's all right.
Well, piss off,
please
then.
Don't. Typical, Beezer. Typical.
Oh, hello, Jude. I didn't think you recognised me.
Nothing changes.
I won't go that far.
Oh, Emma. Come in quickly. Have you shut the door? There are divers, men aboard. That would cause more trouble.
Are you doing?
I am packing. I must needs leave this place. And I urge you to come with me.
I don't understand.
I have been informed upon.
By who?
Philip Footman.
Oh, was he not one of your husband's old customers?
There was a commission at Beckles. I was accused of not observing the ceremonies or the sacraments.
Oh, Alice.
Emma, I cannot. To me, it is idolatry. I welcome the King's break with Rome and the Protestant faith. But I cannot cast it aside like a worn coat just because Queen Mary says that I must.
Come with me to St. Clement's. You can lay low there for a while there. It's quieter.
Quieter? Did you not hear of Agnes Wall's experience the other night? A jumped up priest Argentine sent soldiers to arrest her.
I know.
She escaped because her maid locked her in a cupboard which they were too lazy to search.
I know. I understand the cupboard was very small and she nearly suffocated.
The idiot maid lost the key.
I expect she was
frightened. Oh, she was stupid. Agnes could have died. It was but by the grace of God and her urgent prayer. The key was found just in time.
Oh, Alice, please lay low for a while. Pay lip service to their doctrines.
They have me in their sights, Emma. And I cannot be burned at the stake.
Oh, Wallace, come back with me, please.
And await my death. Peter Moon and his wife have left already, and I must go too.
But what will I do without you?
You have your daughter, Joan, and your two sons.
Sons are not everything.
I have no one. Remember, I lost every one of my children.
You have me?
And you have been a good friend, Emma. But I owe it to my husband's legacy to survive. The great Tully. He had such plans. Who will build these almshouses if I don't?
He had such vision. I only wish Thomas's vision had been half that of your Henry's. His only vision was that ridiculous brass. It cost a fortune and now it will never be completed.
Why, what do you mean?
I'm settled in St. Clement's. I will not return to St. Mary Quay. When I look at it, with all my dead children displayed so, it coldens my heart. No, I shall be buried in St. Clement's and the brass will remain unfinished. You will write.
It will be too dangerous, but I will send word if I can. If I am spared, I intend to live out my days in my mother-in-law's house at St. Clement's. When I return, and we will live out our days in peace, Emma, I have no doubt of that. But now I must go to Darsham. I should not have told you that.
Oh, Alice, let me help you pack.
Thank you.
Double espresso, 3 sugars, right?
Good memory.
I remember everything, actually.
Yeah, I was afraid of that.
So, how long has it been?
A while.
I'd say. And you couldn't phone or text.
You know what I'm like with mobile phones. I've never got any credit.
All right.
Restraining order.
It was 6 months. Only 6 months.
I'd moved on.
Yeah, looks like it.
Thought you had too.
It wasn't me that wanted the split. I just wanted you to sort yourself out.
Yeah, well, you made that perfectly clear.
We couldn't live like that anymore. I couldn't live like that anymore.
Right, sorry.
That's all I wanted to hear.
No, it wasn't. You wanted me to stop smoking, stop drinking,
stop... It was killing you!
It was killing you.
All right. It was killing me.
So do you work here then?
Yes, I'm a volunteer. I wanted to give something back. Mine were very good with counselling and support.
I didn't mean what I said, you know.
No, it was the drink talking.
Addictive personality.
I made 2 attempts, you know.
You what?
Overdose. Pills. Cry for help, really.
So how are you now, then?
Well, I have coping mechanisms. Music helps. Lavender oil.
Are you joking? You ain't come one of these vegans, have you?
You don't get it, do you? I loved you more than I loved myself. I would have done anything. I did do anything. Stealing was the worst.
Well, I didn't ask you to.
You didn't give me much choice. Are you here for art therapy?
I'm here because I have to. They'd stop me benefits if I didn't come.
You might enjoy it.
I only enjoy 1 thing. No, 2 things. No, 3 things, but I don't get any of the things these days.
Oh, are you surprised? Look like you haven't had a bath in months. Smell like it too.
Yeah, well, the streets are a cruel mistress.
Oh, don't give me that. There are hostels.
I don't like the company. Well, don't worry. I just stand on a mate's sofa.
Lucky then. I did my best, you know.
Yeah, well, I blame the army. They don't give a shit, do they? They just send you out into the world with all this baggage on your shoulders.
Look, I could get you some help. Counselling. They do peer support here.
Oh, I'm past it, girl.
No, you're not. Come on, I'll get you another coffee.
Come on, let's have a drink.
Come all you young fellows, as follows the sea. Hey-ho, blow the man down. Beware of the drink, wherever it's free. Give me some time to blow the man down. Blow the man down, bully, blow the man down. Hey-ho, blow the man down. Blow the man down, bully, blow the man down. Give me some time to blow the man down.
Tom! Over here, man, come and join us!
I thought I'd find you here at the Neptune. Well,
can a man not drink to celebrate?
You always seem to have something to celebrate.
And you always seem to have reason not to.
Yes, you know I'm married now.
And what? The lovely Susan wouldn't approve?
It's more that I can't afford it. I did not inherit my father's wealth and estates at the age of 12.
Yeah, an estate in Trimley is hardly going to keep me in the manner to which I intend to become accustomed. Yeah. No, it's more the profits from our voyage. The captured galleons that keep me in bread, my friend.
Well, I'm very pleased for you, but I have other interests now.
Oh, come on, stay for a drink at least. Toast my latest enterprise.
You leave again so soon, but you have nothing left to prove.
I have everything left to prove. Thomas Cavendish, 30 years of age. They call me the navigator, do you know that?
Yes, ironic really, since you were the captain and I was the navigator.
But it was my expedition. We were the first to circumnavigate the globe after Drake. There are other islands to explore, other ships to capture.
Then I wish you well of it.
But I can't do it without my best friend and fellow explorer. Well, come on, Tom.
Does the sea not call to you? Do we not have the best of times?
It was an adventure, I cannot deny it. And if you venture forth again, I wish you well, but I will not be coming.
Ever since we were schoolmates, all we talked about was the sea. The ships we command, the islands we visit, the treasure we capture.
I remember.
We were but 20 when Drake completed his voyage. And I said to you then, that will be us. Do you not remember?
I remember it.
Our ships, the Desire, and the Hugh Gallant. You by my side. Chile, Tierra de Fuego. The Santa Ana with so much treasure you couldn't carry it. The island girls of Guana.
Oh, I remember the girls.
You were as keen to get ashore as anybody. And then there were the sea creatures. The dolphins that followed in our wake. The flying fish. The mermaids!
From the navel upwards, her breasts and her back were like a woman's. Her skin was all white and her long hair behind her. And her tail was like that of a porpoise, speckled like a mackerel.
The sailors all sung about it.
I never saw a mermaid.
No, but they were there, I'm sure of it. And next time we'll see one.
I can't.
I need you.
I can't.
He that travels the world about seeth God's wonders and God's works. Thomas Eldred travelled the world about.
Went out of Plymouth 21st July 1586. Came into Plymouth 9th September 1588.
2 years, 49 days. Yeah. 9 months faster than Drake. They said it couldn't be done. Two unknown boys from the Trimling Marshes.
But that's the point. We've done it. I've done it! I've got the plaque to prove it! I don't need to do it again!
Then who do I take as my right-hand man? You'll force me to take John Davis.
Not Davis here. You know he's not to be trusted.
Well then come. I have 5 ships and a jolly crew.
Yeah, I'm ready.
I can't. You remember the treasure and the mermaids. I remember the sunken ships and the drowned men. The wails and screams as flesh burned on their galleon decks. The endless days and nights as the stocks ran low, the screams and the squabbles and the hunger and the burning sun and the freezing rain.
But that was all part of the adventure.
I hear them often when I pray. I listen for the voice of God, but I hear the drowned voices instead.
Shows your weakness, Tom. You need another voice to toughen you up.
Come on.
And Suzanne is expecting a child, and I have promised her and my father that my seafaring days are over.
Then Davis it is.
Not Davis. I beg if you must go, find another.
Rubbish. If you won't come, it has to be him.
He will bring you down and your voyage will be blighted.
If you change your mind, you'll find me here at the same time tomorrow.
I will be at Stella Maris, praying to Our Lady for your soul.
Hey.
In the crowd that thronged the pierhead, come to see their friends take ship
for new ventures in seafaring, when the hawsers were let slip, and we swung out in the current with goodbyes on every lip. Missed the waving caps and kisses as we dropped down with the tide, and the faces blurred and faded. Last of all, your hand I spied. Farewell, my love, good fortune. Then my heart rose up and cried. While the world holds one such lover, whose sweet honor I regard, who would speed my safe departure, leaving home should not be hard. Shot and coloured with sheer sunlight and the magic of those seas, and the flying fish to see them in the scurry lift and flee. Silver as the foam they sprang from, fragile people of the sea, whom their hearts great aspirations for a moment had set free. Frail as labour, fine as music, the spirits bright exist. Far from stress and storm forever, dream behind a rolling mist, while the long white lines of breakers crumble on your reef.